a minute if we can. I want to introduce some people. They have a special award for one of our students in your class, and who's represented our school, our state, and our region. So we're kind of excited. This is Bob Jones, a good friend of mine. He is the VFW commander for the state. And Richard Pingree, who's a post commander. And Carmelita Jones, Robert's wife, who's also involved with the VFW. But I'm going to turn some time over to them for this special award and announcement.
Well, thank you very much, Jordan. What?
I guess I'm going to tell you who I am. I'm the state president for Idaho for the Veterans of Foreign Wars Auxiliary. It's the family members for the Veterans of Foreign Wars members, and so those who go through are veterans.
It's another beautiful day in southeast Idaho. Every day is Veterans Day, and no one does more for veterans than the Veterans of Foreign Wars. We're members of the Veterans of Foreign Wars, and every year we have a speech contest called The Voice of Democracy. It's for grades 9 through 12, and last year the topic was My Vision for America, and some of you here may have entered. We had a lot of entries from clear across the state of Idaho. We had 496 students participated in this. And we had a post winner in Madison County, then we had a district winner, and the district winner went on to the state, the Department of Idaho, and as our state winner went back to Washington, D.C. and represented the entire state of Idaho in this contest. The first place winner received $1,000 from the Department of Idaho, and an all-expense paid trip to Washington, D.C., and they were also invited to the Freedoms Foundation at Valley Forge. Valley Forge's American Leaders Youth Summit. And we are very, very proud of an individual in your class who was the Madison County winner, the district winner, the state winner, and also placed very high in our national contest in Washington, D.C. She was competing against an individual from every other state plus four overseas departments. So it was an international contest. Now, do we have, and I'm going to pronounce your name wrong because I always have, do we have an Alyssa Dorman here? Wow, it's one of them! Can you imagine this now? We went to the airport, we're flying back to Washington, D.C., and guess who we bumped into in Idaho Falls? Alyssa, it was her first time she had flown. So she was a little nervous in the service, so we flew back with her and got her squared away. She had a wonderful, wonderful time in Washington, D.C., made some new friends for the rest of your life.
Boyfriends? Usually there's love going on with friends.
And she represented us so, so great.
She's
we're
amazing.
So proud of her. Now we're here today with a little presentation to give you. You've already had a lot of things given to you, a lot of recognition. This came from our national headquarters in Kansas City, Missouri. And I'm going to have you look at it here and read a little bit. It's got a picture of our national VFW commander. And it's got a picture of our national auxiliary president. And it says, Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States and Auxiliary, Voice of Democracy National Merit Award, presented to Alyssa Dorman, Idaho. Winner of the National Department of Wyoming and Auxiliary Scholarship in the 2015-2016 Voice of Democracy Program. In witness hereof, we have hereto set our seals in the official seal of the Veterans of Foreign Wars and VFW Auxiliary. John Brugeski, Jr. and Franziska Gilbert, President, Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States of America. So, what we'd like to do is present this to you, Alyssa, and shake your hand and congratulate you. Thank you so much for being a wonderful representative, well deserved. And then we'd like to get all of us in here together and get a picture because we're going to write, get in here, Richard.
All right.
We're going to
stand on this.